Hi. sorry about that. You know how it is, right, with your phone when it dies on you and you set your alarm, right? Everything it's supposed to be working out all right, and you forget to eat breakfast and get all your shirt tucked in and everything else, right? Come on, y'all know what this is all about.
Amen.
When your cell phone's not powered up, because we depend on these silly things so much now, right?
Yeah.
And so it just doesn't work. And so hold on, let me plug this in real quick. That way I'll have it if I need it. Okay, so. Hey, okay, so it's time to start. Okay, so anyway. We live in an interesting world, don't we, today? It seems like everything that we get into anymore, there's always so much disarray, so much stuff going on, so many things pulling us millions of directions, and we get kind of worn out, don't we?
Sure.
We're kind of exhausted, we're kind of tired. It's like, sometimes you're like, oh, who wants to wake up that early morning? Can't church be like 2 o'clock in the afternoon? Come on, Pastor. So you just look at these kind of things. And so we get so worn out and so tired in the world that we're living in. So today is going to be talking about powered up. If you haven't already noticed, we're getting a little bit of power here in my phone. But powered up, okay? And so we first of all have to look at what is our problem.
Yeah.
Because of course, why do we need power, right? Okay. So our problem is we live in a broken world.
Right.
We really do. As people, we live in a completely broken world, a broken society, broken homes, broken neighborhoods, broken cities, broken nation, broken world.
Sure.
Everywhere we turn. And I don't know about you, but I am sick and tired of living a ordinary, everyday, just scrimp, getting by on the very skin of my teeth kind of thing in existence. And the only way to get out of that ordinary existence is to get connected to an extraordinary source.
Amen.
Amen. See, see where I'm going with this, right?
Yeah.
Are you sick and tired of seeing lives destroyed?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, in order to do that, they have to get plugged into an extraordinary source, right?
Right.
We see so many things going on today. I was looking at just YouTube alone, and there are so many things going on in the world today. There is a child abuse is a big thing that was going on. They actually had videos made by the kids themselves showing how these things had happened, the betrayal of what had been going on. Murders happening left and right. Drugs and alcohol drowning our cities, our neighborhoods.
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
And so, you know, so things are going wrong. And the list goes on and on and on and on and on and on. And we decided, we actually in Crossfire Youth had sat down one day and been talking about different things that were going on in our world and why we were here. And we have decided in Crossfire Youth, we are here to make a difference.
Amen.
We're not here to just exist. We're not here to just get by. We didn't come into this world to just go on our little way and then get saved and make it to heaven and that was it. But there's something more to this. And so we have to be powered up to be ready to share and shine the gospel.
Right. Hallelujah.
And I don't know how many of y'all have this, but how many of y'all have that light thing on your phone? Isn't that the coolest thing in the world? Right? And so so we can, should have had that on the front page, but you know, we can shine our little light, and it doesn't look like a whole lot right now because we've got all these other lights on, but I'm telling you, you come in here in the middle of the night, it's dark.
That's right.
And so having a little bit of light is great. But you don't have your light source without your power source, right?
Right.
If my battery was dead, I ain't gonna get nowhere quick.
Right.
Okay. So we see our problem as a broken world. We understand that things are going wrong. In fact, I was listening to a song the other day, and I'm sure some of you are going to be thankful that I didn't play this over the loudspeakers because it's played by a group named Skillet. And so it's a little bit harder, but I did really like the lyrics. So I just want to kind of tell you some of the lyrics. It says, when everything you do don't seem to matter, you try but it's no use, your world is getting blacker. When every time you fail has no answer, every empty promise made is a reminder, no one can make this better, take control of it, it's now or never. And then it says, are you sick of it? And it repeats that over and over again, and if you're sick of it, raise your hands and get rid of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so that was kind of cool, and so that kind of spurred this on just even a little bit more. To me, in fact, it kind of inspired me. Bethany was riding with me over to Lexington to pick up the shirts for our fall retreat coming up. And we were over there, we were listening to the song, and I was just like, all of a sudden, it's like clicked. It's like, oh, Bethany, blah, 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 blah. And I had to tell her because I'd forget if I didn't, you know, get it out in front of me and have somebody else remember for me. So we live in a broken world. We have to understand that things are broken, things are destroyed, we're going through so many things, and things are pulling us millions of different ways, right? So we have to look at our solution. What's our solution? Well, to get powered up, right?
That's right.
And where's our first place? Our first place is our charging station. What's our charging station?
Jesus Christ.
Well, Jesus Christ is our source, but our charging station is church.
Amen.
Right?
Yeah.
Right? Come on, think about it.
Yeah.
Life is pulling us 20 million different directions. We're doing this, this, this. It's like you got work that takes all of your energy, right? And if you're not exhausted enough, then you come home and your family takes all your energy. For the younger people, we got school that takes all our energy. And then we got to come home and our parents expect us to do stuff at home, you know? And then we have to go, and then we go to bed and we get up and do it all over again. Yeah. So we got all these things pulling us so many different ways, and it's taking all of our energy. And so we have to find a place where we can get powered back up.
That's right.
Church is that. Church is our charging station. In Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23 through 25.
Let us hold unswervingly to the hope for we profess, for he who promised is faithful, and let us consider who we may spur one another on towards love and good deeds. Not coming up meeting together as someone are in the habit of doing. But encouraging one another all the more as we say the day approaching.
Okay, so, I mean, that kind of explains it right there, right? It's all about don't give up on your meeting together. Don't forget about coming together, because what? It helps us. It encourages. It strengthens us.
That's right.
Right?
That's right?
I don't know about how many of you, but I don't know how many times I've gone through a week and say for some reason, okay, I miss a service. And it just seems like you get drained that much more throughout your week. And then when you finally come back, you're like, oh, praise the Lord, you know. I got back into it. And so you notice it if you miss it. But there's so many times we really don't understand why we're coming together. A lot of times we come to church, and I'm a huge person involved in this, okay? Because I come to church, and I've got 20 billion things to do at church.
Wow.
So sometimes I forget what church is really about.
Say it.
Okay? Church is not merely just accomplishing a duty that we feel necessary to do, but it's about coming together.
Yes.
To encourage one another, to strengthen one another, to say, how are you doing?
Yeah.
Hey, I missed you last week. Hey, you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There was a person who asked me to, you know, said, when you think about it, pray for me. I was just like, hold on, let's pray right now, you know. And it was just interesting because we come together to encourage each other. We come together to power each other up.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Now, of course, we'll go into just a second, kind of explain that a little bit more. But if we're not powered up, it's kind of hard to power up somebody else. But we do come together to build each other up and charge each other up. And then if we'll look at Proverbs chapter 27, 17. I know this is a familiar passage of scripture, but here we go.
As iron sharpens iron, so another person sharpens another.
Y'all heard the scripture, right?
Yeah.
As iron sharpens iron. I always think of swords, right? Clashing together, right? And we've been showing a lot of swords here lately. I should have came up here and I didn't want to bang them together. I was afraid we'd mess up something or hurt somebody. When iron comes together, it sharpens iron. Okay, they say this. And then I was looking at it, and I was just like, I've been doing a lot of substitute teaching, and it is a blast. I mean, I've been relearning a lot of stuff that I haven't seen in a long time. But one of the things that I thought was kind of interesting is how things come together and elements create what we call energy. Okay? So when when iron comes against iron, it creates friction, and that friction creates energy.
That's right.
So in essence, what those things are doing is when they come together, they're creating an energy source.
Yes.
That's right.
Woo! Y'all kind of just start to calculate, right?
Yeah.
In your head. And so when we go to church, it's an opportunity for us to come together and not just pass each other by, not just miss each other, not just go to our central location and say, okay, I found my seat, I'm in my seat, I'm listening to the pastor, I'm going to go home. But it's about coming together and encouraging and sharpening each other.
Right. We're
charging each other up to be able to go on this journey of life, go out into a broken world,
that's right,
and do more than just survive.
Yes.
Yeah. In fact, I'm getting tired up just talking about it. So we have to get, we have to get powered up, and this is where we're talking about not just a charging station, but about who is your source.
Amen.
God, your source, right? So we have to get plugged in to God. We have to get plugged in to God.
That's right.
I mean, I don't think we comprehend that a lot of times. I don't think we understand that it's about more than just a get-out-of-jail-free card when we come to God. But it's about a source of everything that we have need of inside of God.
Good word.
So when we go to get a charge, we have to have a secure connection. This means when we come to God, we really connect to God. Right? Okay, because think about it. If you have a cell phone, and I've done this a couple of times, how many of you have ever had your cord like not be plugged in all the way? You know what I'm talking about? And then your charge doesn't last as long, you know what I'm talking about, right? And so if I'm partially plugged in all the time, then I'm constantly having to charge my source, right? And so, but the problem with, if I'm doing that, if I'm not always have my source, if I'm not plugged into the correct source, right, then I have to stay partially connected all the time because I don't have enough stuff going on, right? But the problem with that is my cord is only so long and I can only do so many things before I become unplugged.
Right?
So, instead of living my life halfway plugged in, I plug completely into the source, get all the power that I need to be able to go on with God.
Right.
So, here's the thing. The thing is I think the thing we misunderstand a lot of times is, and God was helping me recognize this in prayer. I get so distracted a lot of times, even when I'm praying, that when I pray, it's like I get connected and I say, okay, God, we're going to come to you with my list of prayer requests. And I've got all these prayer requests lined up. Lord, begin to help so-and-so. Begin to help so-and-so. Oh, Lord, by the way, don't forget to help me with my finances. And help so-and-so and help so-and-so. Oh, God, by the way, can you help do this provision? And it's like so many things are going through my brain. I keep on thinking of new things, I think of old things. And God helped me realize, and I spoke this before, which gets really strange because, you know, it's like you wake up and go, oh, duh, I said this before. But when I get connected to God, then I have access.
Right.
Which basically means that if I have a need or if I have something that I'm missing inside of my life and God has it, then by being connected to the source, I have what I need.
Yeah.
Right?
Good.
I mean, think about it. So if I am in need of power, and so basically God was saying, look, I can sit here and I can provide, I can easily provide these things for you left and right. But how about getting connected to me to so much the point where you don't have to ask anymore? You're living in the fullness. You're living in an extra ordinary way. Isn't that neat? And so that's what it's all about. So when we plug into God, we need to make sure to keep our focus on Him. Because, like once again I said, if we're just partially plugging in, we're not getting our full charge. We're not getting all that's out of this. And I say that I haven't been getting all that's out of God. I'm trying to pull more out of God than I ever have before. I'm ready. Okay, God, I'm plugged into it. Let me have that juice, you know. That little electricity, that little voltage. In the scripture that kind of helps us reiterate this fact that we're making today is Matthew chapter 6, verse 33.
But seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well.
Wow. Hello. Wow. I mean, it's in the Word of God. I mean, I'm not making this up. It's real.
Amen.
It's about when I get connected in God, I am connected to the source where I have access to everything. So not only will He energize me to make it through the week, but I'll be able to take on the world.
Right.
And bonus, When I attach into God and get source and energy, I'll also have access to everything that I need.
Yes.
Because it's found in Him.
Yeah.
And so we have to understand that we have to get powered up. We are literally facing a battlefield every time you walk out these doors.
Right.
It's an amazing world we live in. And not so much just in other people's lives, but sometimes in our own lives we face things and we go through things. So we have to learn to get powered up through one another, and then once again attaching into our source, which is God, and making all we have need of. Because, and I was looking at this, you know, a lot of times people look at coming to God as salvation. It's like, oh, I got saved a long time ago, I'm on my way to heaven. And that's good and fine. But God has so much for you even in this life. I think it's what's interesting is in the Bible. In fact, if I, you know, I kind of paraphrase because I don't, you know, I haven't got it memorized quite yet. I'm still getting there. But it says that He has given us life eternal and more abundantly, right? So basically, He's saying throughout the Scripture that He's saying that He has given us life from the point of salvation through eternity.
Right.
Not so much that it only begins once we get to heaven, but it can start right now.
Right.
And so, we can have more. But to get the out of the ordinary into the extraordinary, we have to plug into an extraordinary source.
That's right.
Getting connected to God gets us the life that is beyond what we have.
Amen.
And so when we begin to feel powerless in a broken world, God wants us to live extraordinarily and on those terms,
right.
But it takes us getting connected to Him. That's what it's all about.
Yes.
You know, I was talking the other day, and I was like, you know, I was talking to somebody, and I was like, what happened? You know, we saw you once, we haven't seen you in a long time, what happened? And they said, oh, well, I'm not into that religion thing anymore, I'm just kind of over that. And sadly, you know, God didn't show this to me until a little bit later, but if I see him again, I'm going to make sure to reiterate this. But I started thinking about it, and he was like, I wanted to say, guess what, I'm not into religion either. I'm into a relationship.
Right.
With God.
Right.
I'm connected to a source that I can gain all my power through.
Yes.
And I don't have to worry about going back from time to time and, you know, constantly trying to, you know, find a little plug, a place where I can plug in throughout the week. But I realize that when I get connected to the main source, I have the power that I need to make it.
Yes.
To make it, right?
That's right.
And so am I saying so much that, you know, in order to live a Christian life that you have to come to church? Maybe not. To live an overabundant Christian life, the life that God expects you to live, yes.
Yeah,
why?
Yeah.
Because we energize each other.
Yes.
We lift each other up. We strengthen each other.
That's right. Come on.
And you know, a lot of times we say that, you know, well, I can get God at home. Well, of course you can. But you can't get this kind of connection there.
That's right.
Come on.
You can't get this kind of strength there.
Right.
God said that, I mean, there's strength in numbers. Why did he have to cause so much disarray among the people of the Tower of Babel? Because they were connected to such a point where they could have accomplished anything.
That's right. That's
right? Yes. Because he understands with strength, there's strength in numbers.
That's right.
And so he was saying as we get together, then we have the ability to strengthen one another, and especially more as we see the day approaching.
Yes.
And of course we know that when this scripture was written, that's been quite a while ago. And so we have to understand that it's a little bit closer than it was before.
Yes, sir.
There's a little bit more going on. Now, I'm not saying that God's coming, you know, this afternoon at 6 o'clock or anything like that, but I'm just saying we have to understand that the day is getting even more closer. It's getting more fierce.
Yes.
Satan's more on the attack than he ever was before.
Yes.
And, you know, as long as we're going around just with our, and I started thinking about this, you know, this little light of mine, I don't want a little light anymore. I want to shine with some gusto.
Come on.
So I want some power in my life to where it's not just a little bit.
Come on. Good.
You see what I'm saying? You've had a flashlight, right, with the batteries? If your batteries start to die, your light kind of goes down.
Yeah.
And so, but when it's fully charged, it's like brighter than ever. I got a light that my wife Becky got me that can shine like, you know, from here to probably the next county. It's just, you know, one of those big old power lights. It's awesome. And you know, those are some of the things we think about. So when we're going through our life, we have to realize that we have to get connected to an extraordinary source.
That's right.
And so, God is so good, the way He reminds us of things and the way He brings things to us.
Yeah.
But what we need to understand is that we have to come to God. Now, where that's at and where that happens at is different for each and everybody. But you have to truly get connected to God, who is your source of all your, who is the source of everything that you have needed. We have to get powered up with God.
That's right.
And so, today, I want to thank God so much. God, I want to thank you for blessing us. I want to thank you for keeping us. And Lord, I want to thank you for putting some power in us to be able to live extraordinary lives and to be able to be a light shining for others that the world may see what you've given us. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for being such a blessing to us and such an amazing, wonderful Father and such an amazing and wonderful source. I thank you for blessing us, Lord Jesus. And so what I'd like to do today is I would like to open up some charging bays here at the altar. I'd like to open some charging bays that you can truly come to Him and say, God, I just need more of you. I don't need you to answer this request and this request so much. I'm not worried about these specific little things that are going on in my life, Lord Jesus. But I just need more of you. I need your power to flow through my veins.
Yes.
I need the thing that you talked about so many times in the Bible, Lord Jesus, that I'm going to seek after you and I'm going to find you.
Yes.
I'm going to have what I need to make it through because, Lord Jesus, you are my source.
Yes.
It's not about the answers we receive on the other side, but it's about getting connected to the source. And we praise you and we thank you. So today I'd like to open up the charging bays here at the altar area that you could come and get connected back to God in such an amazing way because He is here today to give you some extraordinary power to be able to go out and live more abundantly than you ever have this week.